Step into a forgotten realm where a reptilian giant reigned supreme, defying the rise of mammals during the age of mammals. Brace yourself for a captivating journey as we uncover the awe-inspiring tale of Barinasuchus, the colossal reptile that stood as the largest terrestrial predator in an era dominated by mammals. From the middle of the Eocene epoch to the middle of the Miocene epoch, the Barinasuchus was an animal that existed throughout the early Cenozoic period. During the time period referred to as the Age of Mammals, it is believed to have been the biggest known terrestrial predator that ever existed. As is the case with the other members of the Svenisida family, this enormous reptile, which is thought to have reached lengths of up to 10 meters, spent its whole existence on land. It differed from other semi-aquatic crocodilomorphs in that it possessed lengthy legs, which made sprinting a more natural choice for it than swimming. This enormous reptile, which has been given the name Barinas after the location in Venezuela close to where one of the specimens was discovered, is thought to have been around the same size as an Allosaurus. What fascinating adaptations allowed Barinasuchus to possess teeth resembling serrated knives and jaws strikingly similar to those of the theropod dinosaurs, known for their serrated teeth? Now let's shed some light on it. It possessed teeth that resembled serrated knives and had a head the size of Dasplodosaurus, which was a direct progenitor of Tyrannosaurus rex. Its jaws were remarkably similar to those of the theropod dinosaurs, which had serrated teeth. Barinasuchus was a species of prehistoric reptile that, like many other extinct reptiles, resembled current crocodilians, but it was really a member of the family Svenisida. In contrast to other sevicids, Barinasuchus lived on land rather than in a semi-aquatic environment. The Barinasuchus possessed lengthy legs that were positioned directly beneath its body, much to the way that huge mammalian predators do. These were great for jogging on land, but not at all suitable for the pool. There have only been 3 Barinasuchus specimens discovered, and none of them featured bones located farther back than the head. Barinasuchus was a dinosaur that lived in what is now South America. Its diet most likely consisted of a wide range of mammals, birds, and other reptiles that existed throughout the Miocene. How have these fossil finds contributed to our understanding of the physical anatomy and size of Barinasuchus? What unique features and adaptations have been revealed through these discoveries? Based on the fossils that were already in the collection, B. arvoloi was classified as a member of the Svenisida family. We now know a little bit more about the other members of this family. If other species are any indication, the Barinasuchus would have had long legs that were positioned straight beneath its body. It is likely that these legs appeared and functioned more similarly to those of huge mammalian predators than they do those of current crocodiles. Using other reptiles as a basis for comparison, the length of its body is believed to have been anywhere between 6.3 and 10 meters, which is equivalent to 20 to 32 feet. At the time, this animal was at least 50% bigger than the next largest terrestrial predator that existed. Because there are no bones that can be examined, determining its weight is more difficult. The researchers estimate that it weighed somewhere in the range of 1,610 to 1,720 kilos, which is around 3,500 to 3,800 pounds. The theropod known as Allosaurus fragilis was around the size of this object. On the basis of the 3 specimens that are now in existence, the length of the skull of the arvoloi is estimated to be between 95 centimeters and 115 centimeters, and its height is around 40 centimeters. The length of the snout was nearly the same as that of Dasplodosaurus, which is a theropod dinosaur that is believed to be the direct progenitor of Tyrannosaurus rex. The huge snout of this ancient crocodile was shorter and deeper in comparison to its size than the snouts of current crocodilians. It possessed a greater number of points at which muscles may have joined, which contributed to its very powerful bite. The Barinasuchus possessed teeth that were similar to those of the theropod dinosaurs. They had a structure known as zephodont, which meant that they were compressed laterally, serrated, and curled rearward. These razor-sharp, serrated edges of the teeth, which resembled the blade of a gigantic steak knife, were well-suited for tearing through flesh. How did this reptilian behemoth utilize its unique adaptations to dominate the prehistoric landscape and secure its place as an apex predator? Watch till the end to learn more about it. The Barinasuchus was the biggest terrestrial predator that ever lived. Hence, it most likely consumed pretty much every animal that came into its path. Due to the fact that it lived during the early stages of the Cenozoic, its prey would have most likely consisted of other reptiles, mammals, and maybe even huge birds. When hunting, the Barinasuchus probably needed to preserve as much energy as possible due to the speed of its metabolism. It would have been simple for it to accomplish its goal by simply waiting, hiding itself along the trails through the woods, and then ambushing its target in a swift assault. Based on the age of the rocks that surround the three fossils of Barinasuchus, we may deduce that this species existed between the middle of the Eocene period and the middle of the Miocene epoch. Based on this information, its first appearance might have occurred somewhere between 56 and 33.9 million years ago. It is thought to have died out sometime during the Miocene period, which occurred around 12 million years ago. What factors allowed Barinasuchus to thrive on land, even in the face of abundant water resources such as marshes and rivers that dominated its habitat in northern South America? To this day, there have been the discovery of three specimens, all of which were located in the western region of what is now known as South America. Barinasuchus spent its whole existence on land rather than in the water, despite the fact that a large portion of northern South America was covered in vast marshes and rivers. It is quite probable that Barinasuchus was the top predator in the environment and time period in which it existed. As a consequence of this, it is possible that it encountered challenges in the shape of enormous reptile rivals. On the other hand, it was very unlikely that any other predators would consume it. Alterations in both the planet's geology and its climate are regarded to have been the most significant challenges faced by this reptile. In South America, specimens of Barinasuchus have been discovered in three different localities. In the Divisadero Lago formation of Argentina, strata dating back to the middle of the Eocene era have yielded at least one specimen. The other two were discovered in strata that dated back to the middle of the Miocene era.